Oh, shit. Okay, good. I didn't sneeze. Thank you. hi. Okay. Well, where's my camera? Where's my camera? Hello! Welcome. It's day 115. Now, a little thing, because it is now April. That means that we have less than 30 days before my super special VR surprise thing that I ordered almost a year ago shows up in the mail. I'm super excited for it to get here. I can't wait to use it. It's gonna be really fun. I've been waiting for this for a while. I wanted to get here as soon as possible, but I do have to give them patience because the company has been through a lot of trouble. Anybody who's deep into the VR scene probably knows exactly what I'm talking about, just given that information. But I am only saying this with secrecy because I'm still kind of keeping it as a surprise for my poly group and my boyfriends and all that. So, that's why. But if you know, you know. Yeah, other than that, the printer did kind of fuck up a little bit. Not this last night, but it's been being a little fucky. I'm going to go check on it in couple minutes here once I finished with this recording, but I'm like worried that it might fail again because that printer has just been really finicky. Not the Ender. The Ender is actually working fantastic, other than the bed needed to be leveled a little bit better, but the Creality CR10 is still having a lot of issues. I'm really excited for Saturday. I'm hoping that I can go shopping and get some girl stuff with my friend. I'm not hype about the fact that I just got a very fun letter in the mail that I will not digress, but long story short, I'm going to be spending a lot of money paying a very big bill that I had forgotten about. Demons of my past self decided that they were going to be stupid and make unwise purchases, and now I'm paying the consequences now. However, I'm hoping that with me working 6 days a week, I should be able to pull that off and still have money to save for moving out. But obviously, donations are still appreciated, and I thank anybody who can and has already. But as I can't really compensate back to anybody who has or would want to, I'm not trying to force anybody or ask or beg, because I really, like, I feel so grateful taking whatever I can get. But I also feel bad because I just can't give anything back other than myself. It is what it is, though. I will do as best I can, and any extra help is greatly appreciated. I am still working on a tier system. I'm trying to figure out exactly what I want as rewards, but I'm telling you, I'm thinking some of the rewards are probably going to involve sales on things that I designed in my 3D printing shop. Some might be like more control, not control, but more influence over the kind of videos that I make. Potentially even being able to get collaborations and making videos with me. It's an option. I could put that in there. I just don't know what tier to put all this on, of course. I'm still new to the whole Ko-Fi thing. I mean, that's really all I got. Just... Oh, I am getting over my sickness. I'm not as sick anymore, although unfortunately at work I did end up rolling my ankle that I'd already injured again, so that ankle is now going to be healing longer. I'm going to be wrapping an ACE bandage around it, and after this having happened, one of the things that I'm going to be buying soon is I'm going to be going to the store, probably like a pharmacy or something, and just I'm going to put together like a small like sort of field kit that I can take with me everywhere, like with like things like ibuprofen, burn cream, ACE bandages, gauze, all sorts of stuff that I could just, you know, might need for injuries, because unfortunately it seems like I get injured quite a bit now. Not just at work, I'm just very clumsy and I tend to get hurt quite a bit. And this ankle is starting to hurt a bit, so I'm definitely going to take care of that when I get off the video. But yeah, I'm probably going to be putting that together for myself. I have my own little med kit that I can carry around for me. Field medical kit, whatever. I gotta look into that and see what I all need to add. Hey, if anybody has things that they would recommend adding to a field med kit, just for like walking, like daily walking around and like maybe like work accidents in like an industrial facility, let me know. I don't think I'll need a tourniquet, But I could probably throw one in there just because, like, you know, you never know. And I like to be prepared for anything. Even if I'll probably never end up using it, it's still good to have it and not need it than to need it and not have it. But, like, seriously, if you guys know anything, if any of you guys are medical experts and, like, can think of anything, like, hey, you should toss this in. Or, oh, this is a really good product you should definitely get. Let me know. And I will add that to the list when I go get to go shopping for, I need to go shopping for food, girl stuff, and medical supplies. But yeah, it sucks when, you know, you work at a company and the only amount of ace bandage they have to wrap your foot in is a foot of, like, literally 12 inches of ace bandage is all they had. And that was barely enough to get, like, two wraps around with how much I was stretching it, which did hold everything in place okay, but it would have been nicer to be able to have a little more slack to work with. But anyway, oh, there was some kind of special tape that served like a K that was like more flexible. I can't remember what it was called, but somebody recommended that. Anyway, I will see you guys in the next one, and y'all have a good day.